Salute, comrades, and welcome back to Let's Play Republic Revolution. Today, one of our comrades is being captured by the police. Yeah, here he is. And this is quite bad, actually. It triggers the whole new scenario, the whole new thing with dealing with the police institution in this city and in this country. So one of our members have been caught and thrown to the prison just because he was a member of our party. So this is not very nice of them. So first off, we have to check out the police headquarters for signs of who are commanding with all this arrest thing. And then we will be fine. Okay, this is the police station, and we found it. So, okay, comrades, let's go back to the topics that I'm eager to discuss. And that exact topic went from my one of my viewers, Kerry123, and he asked me to talk about myself. So I will do this. First of all, my full name is Vadim Stanislavovich Sidov. I was born in the heart of the Soviet Union in Moscow, long time ago. I went to local school, I did quite nice there. Then I've actually won the school's intellectual contestment or something like that. Intellectual marathon, I guess that was called. I've even went for the town's marathon, but I wasn't quite prepared for that. So, but still, I've been like in top 50, and I guess they did that marathon in not the most honest way, because I've seen many flaws in the judgment. Okay, then I went to Moscow Institute of Radioelectronic and Automation. I went first on the specialty of microelectronics, then I've turned to the non-technology group. I was actually one of the best students in this university, and I've even won one of the Olympiad on the higher mathematics, on the math. It was something around 2 or 3 years ago, or 3 or 4 years ago. And I've been the institutional championship, I've been the regional Olympiad, and I've even taken the third place in the higher math on the international championship. Actually, not only our institute's group, which I lead, took the third place in statistics, in mathematical statistics, in the Moscow region. So that's mainly because I have had I've practiced a lot with numbers, with system thinking. Yes, this type of game, like hard simulators, strategy games, help my brain to develop. I've learned from them how to look at things, the cause and effect. Playing that type of games helped me realize, after playing that type of game, I've started to realize how the sheets work, how the systems work, how to tweak systems in the way that help you need. So after a while I was just very good with equations, like, and not like I'm in a geek way, but I'm comfortable with them. One of my first strategy games, actually the very first one was Duna 2 on the Sega Genesis, but I didn't play it that much. I've played real strategy game was Civilization 2, and maybe you don't even remember this game, but it was in the time it was a very interesting game, because it showed you, it was the first really complicated game that I have. The other one was Railroad 2, Tycoon 2. I've played this game from now and then, just to remind myself how hard this game is. And at first you think that this game is, it's not that punishing, yes, you can like handle yourself in this game process. But the thing is, when you have to beat some type of mission, you have to really plan forward, plan your strategy to take strong decisions and so forth. So even now, I cannot say that I will beat this game in the first try, every level of this game in the first try. And I've played Railroad Tycoon 3 with a 3D graphics, and it lost almost all of its charm because of concentrating on the graphic more. So let's go back to me. The last year was the toughest one in my life, because I've graduated the summer of 2008, and right after I graduated I was have to go to the army for a month, to Russian army, because I've completed the military was my third higher education in Russia. The first one was nanotechnology when I've graduated. The second one was the English language, because when I've studied in the university, in the morning I've studied the nanotechnology, and at the evening, in the evenings I've studied English. I went to the English class. And the third one was the military education, as one day per week was the day for a military class in a university. So I, by the terms of this education, I was have to go to the real army. It was a regiment in the Kursk, and this was quite an experience. I've seen the modern Russian army. I won't tell you about it anything, but it was quite a trip. So now I am officially lieutenant in the specialty of radio of electronic warfare. So yeah, obey my commands, privates. What else can I say? My diploma period, when I have to do this scientific researches and to write my diploma, that was one of the least pleasurable years of my life, because the laboratory where I was working, that during that time. It wasn't a very modern stage since the Soviet period, so it wasn't fun at all. So I was pushing through as hard as I can, and I did it actually. I got because of that I've got my red diploma, so like to the best students. To casual students they give blue diplomas, and for me I have a red diploma, so I'm just cooler than they are. Or hotter, I don't know. It's better to be hotter than cooler. Well, what do you think, Yula? What is better to be hotter or cooler, in your opinion?